We are live from Whole Foods, actually, and if you happen to be in the area, come on by and say hi. Where are we exactly, Art?
We are at Ashland and Belmont in the north side of the city.
My favorite Whole Foods in Chicago. It's big, and they have these huge windows here, so the lighting is great. You'll oftentimes find me here filming during the week and all that good stuff, but we have time today. So I actually scheduled this ahead of time, which is unheard of for a shop with me.
Unheard.
And I want to do a healthy shop along live with Arthur T. Almasy, but these are all about you. Whenever we do live shop alongs, they're very, very exciting because they don't happen often, right?
It's kind of
like an eclipse, some might say, right?
Something like that.
But they're for you, right? I can go around and talk about stuff forever. Maybe I'll do a little bit because I never know how to stop talking. But you guide the live stream. You ask questions and we answer them in real time. We're fully checked in right here. It says Arthur for filming and Bobby for filming. So hopefully we shouldn't have any problems. Unfortunately, Doug, the manager's off today. So hopefully his replacement won't have any issues. But what do they normally do for a live stream? What's the protocol here, Art?
Protocol is you opine, you talk, we try and deliver. We can't get to everything, but we do our best.
We do. Also, we love to let everyone know where we're watching from. Please leave a comment down below. Let us know where you're watching from. Once again, we're in Chicago at Ashland and Belmont, the big Whole Foods, hanging out on Taco Tuesday, which when we're done, we're going to go home and make some tacos with Rose. So let's get started. I want to start in this aisle because actually, this is my favorite aisle in Whole Foods and any grocery store, the bulk food section. Now, this is relatively new because they took it away for Corona, which I understand, but when they took it away, it's like a dagger in my heart because you save big money. You're not paying for the packaging. You put everything in a plastic bag or whatnot, and it's cheaper. So I get some black wild rice here. I'll get some nuts here. I get the organic split lentils, but look what's still out, Art. There's a national shortage on wild rice. This is from California. It's been empty for months. And $8.49 is a good price, but did you see my Trader Joe's haul the other day? They have it for $5 a pound from the USA. The reason why I love wild rice, compared to even brown rice, and obviously compared to white rice down here, is, guys, white rice is this right here. It's brown rice, right? That has the outer hull and bran taken away. So to me, I call this dead food because there's really no nutrition in here. A step up would be here. The brown rice has the hull and the bran and the fiber on there. So it's way more nutrient dense. But if we leapfrog over here, the wild rice is even better because there's more protein, there's more fiber. And Art, I believe wild rice isn't even rice at all. What is it again?
It's an aquatic grass.
It's an aquatic grass. So even though it's a grass, it's still technically not paleo because it's called a pseudo grain, but you have to be careful with certain rice from around the world for heavy metals, specifically arsenic. California rice, if this is from California, Lundberg. See this name right here, Art? This is one of the best names in Office Space, obviously the movie.
That was actually Lundberg.
Oh, really? Oh, that's a bummer. But also for rice. But other parts of the world can be high in arsenic. The cool thing about wild rice is that it's a wild and crazy guy, and it's not rice. It's a grass, so there's zero heavy metals. It's the most nutrient dense, which is why if you go in my new cookbook to page is the fried rice recipe on? I do a fried wild rice with chicken with 5 ingredients. It's amazing. Cookbook link is down below. A few things in the description box. Click the link down below or the little arrow. Cookbook, order on Amazon. It's a number one bestseller, all because of you. You're gonna love it. The Immune Tea is back in stock today. We have 1,000 units. We already sold 500. So if you want the Flav City Immune Tea, link down below. And all my Amazon kitchen gear that I use for cooking every day is down there below. They make great Christmas presents. So I love this stuff, but even in the bulk section, it's not as cheap as Trader Joe's. Get it there. And I wanna show you some other stuff here, but what's going on, Art?
Hey, whoever asked about peppercorns, just go to Costco and buy the Kirkland Tellicherry black peppercorns.
Yep.
That's what Bobby gets. Your chicken nuggets, are they paleo?
They are paleo. They're actually paleo and keto because I use
Windmuller was saying, hey, does Bobby have a paleo chicken nugget recipe?
Yep.
And he does.
Go to FlavCity.com, click on the recipe index. It's paleo and low carb because I use chicharrone. If you want to make it paleo, you could also use almond flour.
What's a good tahini?
A great tahini, either on Amazon or at Walmart, is called Mighty Sesame Co. The biggest test for tahini, we can go over there. Actually, I'll save that. I'll save it. Remind me to go back over there. It's good. We're in the grocery store. I'm going to show you all. Now, Art, over here, there's a lot of prepackaged stuff. I don't buy this stuff typically at Whole Foods. It tends to be expensive. But I love this company, and there's a version of this at Costco. So there's two very important things on this packaging here, and they're both great for immune system. Pumpkin seeds are amazing for your immune system, and sprouted is fantastic. So you see the word sprouted a lot. You'll most likely see a sprouted with bread. What does that mean? Is it a big deal? Is it worth paying more for? Who cares? It is a big deal. You shouldn't pay that much more, but sprouted means you take the grain or the seed and you sprout it, typically by soaking it in water and sprouting it. When you do that, really, really good things happen. It reminds me of Tom Green in Road Trip. What happens, Art?
Unleash the fury.
It unleashes the fury, Mitch, because when you sprout something, you release more nutrients, release more enzymes, and make it easier on your tum-tum to digest. So in this case, it does that, but pumpkin seeds are very high in zinc. One serving has 20% of your daily recommended intake of zinc. More importantly, 45% of copper, 60% of manganese, 30% of phosphorus in only a quarter cup, and magnesium also helps you sleep at night. Eat a quarter cup of this while you're watching The Mandalorian, which for some reason I like, and I don't even like Star Wars. I'm watching it. So darn good for you, but go to Costco, not the same company. They have a great big bag for the best price. Pumpkin seeds are a must for your immune system to make you strong like bull.
I'm going to ask D. Brown. I might not know every recipe's page number, but I know that the fried rice is not on 119.
Very, very true.
He says it's page 83. Thank you, D.
Thank you, D. Page 83 of the new cookbook. Order down below. And I'll ask you one favor. If you bought the cookbook, please leave an Amazon review. Even if you haven't bought the cookbook, you can still leave a review if you wanted to. And just leave an honest review. Those are very important for Amazon search rankings.
Hey, Sarah Windmuller, Bobby's email is bobby@flavcity.com.
Yes, indeed.
bobby@flavcity.com.
Okay, let's go selfie style and welcome everyone again. Hello, everyone. Arthur.
Hi, everybody.
Some nice words of wisdom for a Taco Tuesday.
Put some pulled pork on your taco. I think you're going
to
like it.
We were just talking about making beef tacos tonight. And I go to Art, what do you normally garnish a taco with? He's like,
start it down the road,
yeah,
as usual.
Tomatoes, cheddar cheese, guacamole. And then he drops
Pulled pork.
I'm like, but somehow he does that with everything we talk about. Okay, 600 people watching. Leave comments down below. Let us know where you're watching from, all that good stuff.
Ooh, yes, Dr. Art. Wow, cool.
Armando, the big news came out last week. We are moving to Florida next year. Pico de Gallo is great too. Soap and body wash. Yeah, I haven't done that yet, but I'll check it out. Body, you gotta wash the body. So someone asked about tahini. And remember, this is all for you, the Shop With Me Live. So ask any question you have about any product, any aisle, and we'll go there. Best eggs at Trader Joe's are the Chino Valley ones, by far. Is black rice healthy? Yes, but not as healthy as wild rice, I'd say. We used avocado oil spray for our eggs and it burnt them. Why?
I think the heat burnt them.
Yeah, your heat was too high, and the avocado oil spray should be propellant free, but yeah, I would add some more oil and lower the heat. Okay, so Art, let's cozy over here. So another great thing we buy in the bulk section is this. Not keto, not paleo, but there's a recipe in the cookbook for 5-ingredient red curry lentils. Lentils have to be organic. That is a must. Otherwise, conventional lentils score high in glyphosate, the active ingredient in Roundup. These are split down the middle. So they cook literally in 20 minutes. In the cookbook, we do lentils, red Thai curry paste as your flavor bomb from the grocery store, kale, mirepoix, and bone broth. Oh my God, 5 ingredients, never tasted better. Check them out using my Amazon link down below. This is another great section that is underappreciated at Whole Foods, and it was gone for about 5 months because of COVID. It's back, not fully, but it's back. Spices in bulk are a fraction of the price of spices in the glass containers. These are fresh, they get turned over very often. Freshness really counts when it comes to ground spices. Peak freshness is for 5 months. After that, it really goes downhill. Is it good 10 months later? Well, yeah, of course it's good, just like coffee's good 2 months later, but the flavor goes downhill because when you grind a spice, the volatile essential oils are exposed to the air and they go downhill in flavor. So only buy an ounce or two at a time, or buy a dime bag like Art does, right? And then go through it and buy some more. What's so funny, Art?
I'm laughing at Lisa Kurtz's follow-up question on the eggs. She said, I thought you didn't like Chino Valley pasteurized eggs in your video.
You said that.
Tell us that story.
First of all, save that story for a second. That's the best one at Trader Joe's. So I get all my favorites here. My favorite is smoked paprika, which I don't see right now, but compare the prices to the stuff in the container, a fraction. One of my favorite teas that I literally drink every morning is this, jasmine green tea. It seems like it's a lot, but you would never buy a pound. You honestly buy like a quarter pound that'll last you a month or two. Loose leaf, meaning it's not ground into a powder. It's the whole dried leaf. Organic is a must when it comes to tea, especially from other parts of the world. Tea farming that's non-organic can be sprayed with pesticides and chemicals that are illegal in the US, and tea leaves soak up all that crap, right? So you really want to get organic. It's very important. I love this tea. And then I always have a few cinnamon sticks on hand because I actually put these in some stews, like Moroccan stews or like Thai stews, and it infuses a nice flavor in that. Okay, there's a question about tahini. Anything else to add, Art?
We got a super chat just now from Maritza Castello, $5. Teton Wafer Waters sells sausages with citrus flour. Is this okay?
Oh, yeah. You know what? Teton is fantastic. I haven't seen that one. Citrus flour is another word of like lemon zest that's been ground into a powder. That sounds great. We're going to walk over to the tahini section, and I'm going to tell you a story about Trader Joe's Chino Valley. So many, many moons ago, I said that Chino Valley.
Going to shoe cam now.
Yeah, shoe cam, yeah. Or horse feed cam. I said Chino Valley wasn't very good. But I got some bad advice from the Cornucopia Institute. It turns out that it is really pasture raised. They're not organic at Trader Joe's, which is a knock, because I prefer organic pasture raised. But they're pretty much equivalent to Vital Farms. I would just prefer to get organic, which they don't have there. But yes, if you're at Trader Joe's, it is the best around. No one's ever gonna put them down. Okay. So then after that video came out, the CEO of the company emailed me and he's like, I'm a big Flav City fan, so I'm watching this Trader Joe's video and I hear this and I was devastated. And so we hopped on the call, we figured it out, and I apologized. And in a later Trader Joe's video, I fixed my mistake. So yes, thank you. Okay, there should be tahini here, I feel like.
I feel like tahini tonight.
Let's let the people help us find it. Do we see any tahini? Oh, Art, your favorite carrot ketchup's on sale.
Yeah.
That's actually a pretty good deal. Maybe it's in another aisle.
It might be.
Yeah, I bet it's all over by the international stuff, maybe.
It's with the nut butters, according to
Google. Oh, yeah, nut butters. Thank you. Yeah, let's go over there. Okay.
Gene wants to know if bone broth is better than regular broth.
Yes. Bone broth is better not only in flavor and texture, but for nutrition. There's way more collagen, gelatin, and chondroitin. We'll go over there next. Tahini bone broth. If there's one thing I can't live without, it's bone broth. Bone broth and really good extra virgin olive oil. Bone broth is a vital ingredient in my new 5-ingredient cookbook. I keep talking about it. Why not?
Carol, don't believe the hype. I've never actually had carrot ketchup. Bobby's just...
Yeah, he's never actually had it.
Yeah.
Bone broth adds a great body and richness because of the gelatin, but the way it really boosts your immune system and your gut is fantastico. Okay, here we go. Tahini down here, perfect. So I've got this one before. This is the Whole Foods tahini. So what is tahini? It's basically a sesame seed version of peanut butter, ground sesame seeds. It's gonna be probably from Israel, product of Israel, but the actual seeds come from Ethiopia, is my guess. And that's it, it's one ingredient, ground sesame seeds, and they make it the same way they would peanut butter. The thing is, and you can't really see it here, but tahini has to be runny, loose, and pourable. So if I open this right now and went like that and it didn't stream out, I'd put it back. Going back to Trader Joe's, if you buy the Trader Joe's tahini, it's garbage in my opinion because it's the thickest stuff. I was in Israel with Desi about 3 years ago, and I went to a really old school tahini factory in Jerusalem, in Old Jerusalem, and they taught us all about tahini. And the guy made it with this old, really, like pestle and mortar and wheel. And if it's thick, that means it's bitter. It's the bottom of the barrel. It must be runny, loose, and pourable. My favorite brand is Mighty Sesame Company. You can get it at Walmart or at Amazon. Just make sure it's runny, loose, and pourable. The 365 one's pretty good too, to be honest.
Is olive oil better than avocado oil?
No, you can't make that statement. Really good avocado oil, I'd say just as good as really good extra virgin olive oil. There's cooking extra virgin olive oil, and there's finishing extra virgin olive oil. That's a great thing to talk about too. So we talked about tahini. We have to talk about bone broth now, right, Tuart? Okay, we're gonna walk over there. In the meantime, keep leaving comments down below. How many people are watching, Art?
792.
All right, 792. Maybe give you a chance to share and say hi. Let us know where
is,
you're watching from.
Salted tahini good?
You don't really want to add salt to it, but if there is a little bit, it shouldn't be that big of a deal because you're most likely going to use it in a savory recipe. All right. Excuse me. It's a cold but a beautiful day here on the north side of Chicago. And we're rocking and rolling. How's it going?
Hi.
Nice to see you. Good, good, good. That's all good? No. Okay. So here, this is actually probably a wall of products that has so many questions. What's the difference between beef broth and beef bone broth? What's the difference between stock and bone broth? So basically, usually, broth is made with the meat and the bones. Stock is made with the bones. But bone broth is made with bones, necks, femurs, collagen-rich bones. So I know it's expensive or more expensive, but my favorite are these guys. So what exactly is this? This is Austin-based. What up, Chris? Everything good is in Austin right now. It's crazy. This is bone broth. It's about 24-hour simmered. Simmer down, Art.
If you're doing your own beef stock at home, that's pretty much what
yes,
you're doing.
Yes, it's
anyway,
very close
so.
To it. You're right. Beef bone broth, which is grass-fed bones, onions, garlic, onions, carrots, parsley, just seasonings. But what happens is you simmer this for 24 hours. What happens in that whole process is all of the minerals, the collagen, the gelatin, something called chondroitin, gets released from the bones. And this is so thick and luscious that it makes soups and stews and chilies and sauces so much better. You can make your own. And once again, we thought of everything in this cookbook, which is why you're loving it, which is why it's number one bestseller. In our new five-ingredient semi-homemade cookbook, there's a five-ingredient version of this. Because I use it a number of times in the recipe book, I say, hey, if you're at the store, buy this one. Or if you're gonna make your own, use my recipe. The reason why I use it so much is because when you only have five ingredients, you gotta make each one count. And using this versus water, using this versus stock is night and day. So for my red Thai scallop soup, for my lentil curry, for my sauces, for a few recipes, I use this. And I teach you, if you're gonna buy your own, what to look for, what to avoid, all that good stuff. Once again, in the description box, check it out on Amazon. I think there's a return policy, so for God forbid you didn't like it, I'm pretty sure you can return it, but I think you're gonna love the cookbook down there. You want bone broth. My favorite brand is this. Another good one is called Bare Bones. Another good one is called, I forgot the name of it right now. But either way, you can't go wrong. Another one I drink too is, they make some soups. A couple have natural flavors, which I told them to get rid of. But I drink this one too. This is organic butter chicken bone broth. And it's delicious. I try to have a cup a day to keep the doctor away.
Have you tried Kettle on Fire's chicken broth?
I haven't tried that one. I much prefer bone broth over that.
Somebody asked, what's the best salmon at Whole Foods? Is the wild-caught salmon okay if it's from China?
No, they don't have any wild-caught salmon from China here. And I stay away from all wild-caught fish from China. Their fishing practices and their standards there are much, much lower.
Oh,
you don't want that. You need help? Okay.
Yeah.
Sometimes you'll see something where it's caught in the U.S., sent to China for processing, and then sent back here. Like, you'll see that at cheaper stores like an Aldi or a Dollar Tree. Stay away from that. That's not ideal at all. Okay, what else do we got here? Yeah, what are you looking for?
Is it confectioner sugar?
Confectioner sugar would be another word for powdered sugar.
Okay.
And it wouldn't be right here. It'd be, let's see, over here.
Further down.
White sugar,
white sugar. Okay.
AKA the devil. Let's see. Do we? Oh, you know what? It's fresh out.
Okay.
There's just a little remnants here.
I thought they also have other brands out there.
That's it.
Okay.
Yeah. Sorry. What are you gonna use it for?
I'm gonna
to make cookies.
What kind of cookies? Oh, you got a cookie cookbook. Wow.
I'm going to make these, so it's for the glaze.
Can we show this on the camera, too?
Oh, sure.
Yeah, thanks. Just going to make this here. Oh, for the glaze. Interesting. Yeah. You know you can make your own powdered sugar at home, right?
How do you do that?
Art, powdered sugar, you just put cane sugar in the food processor, right?
I haven't done that, but I've seen you do it with monk fruit.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm making these. Yeah.
Oh, whoopie pies. That sounds great.
Yeah, and then that's going in the filling with the marshmallow.
Oh, okay. Just make it at home.
Okay.
Yeah, Google search it. I think you pulse it in the food processor for about a minute, but you'll see it'll turn from like granulated to powdered. It'll fly a little bit here and there, but it's pretty easy.
Okay.
Just make sure it's fine enough. You don't want to feel the granules too much.
Okay.
It should feel like, yeah, put your finger on here.
Yeah.
It should feel just like that.
Almost,
yeah,
right.
Exactly. It should look like Escobar's lab, though, just like that. Yeah. All right.
All right, cool. All right,
enjoy. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, you too.
Yeah,
take care.
Yeah, caster sugar.
Yeah. The funny thing is, so that is a great segue. I want to do a video, and I don't think I can because I'd get kicked out of the store, but I want to basically walk around and tell people that they're buying the wrong stuff. So it'd be like, I dress up as like an Amazon shopper or something. I mean, she assumed I worked here. I actually have a Whole Foods hat and an apron they sent me, but I want to go to Costco and Whole Foods and whatnot and pretend I worked there. And the video would be like me walking around helping people and telling them to stop buying this one and buy this one instead and explain just like that. I think it'd be a cool video. What do you guys think?
Oh, you got a super chat from Maria Martinez.
Maria.
What gelatin does your wife use for the key lime pie?
There's a great gelatin from Trader Joe's. It's grass-fed gelatin from Great Lakes, but I guarantee they have something here.
Whoever just asked about getting the bones out of the salmon, ask the fishmonger to do
for you. Always ask the fishmonger to do that. They're more than happy to do it. Gelatin. I don't know exactly where it is, but yeah, just look for ideally grass-fed gelatin. That'd be nice.
We got a super chat from Louis Caralex 12.
Louis
Miles Forever, $4.99. Thank you.
Thank you, Louis and X Miles. I appreciate that. Okay, we've covered some good ground. Let's go back to the cooking oils aisle because I know we kind of cover it every time. I think cooking oils are super important. Someone had a question earlier about what's better, avocado oil or olive oil? And let's go answer that question. While we mosey on over there, keep leaving comments down below. And if you want to take the link to the stream and share it to like Instagram or Facebook, the more the merrier.
Somebody said your show idea is a lawsuit waiting to happen.
It's all right, I got Jackie Childs, the attorney at law. No, but it's a great idea, you gotta admit. You kind of see previews of that, like when I'm shooting solo at Costco and I tell people they're buying the wrong thing. I don't do it in a mean way, but most people, 9 out of 10, appreciate it. So there's a great question. There's a big wall of fats behind me. What's better, olive oil or avocado oil?
That's like shampoo versus conditioner.
Oh my God, it's like Billy Madison in real life. I'm living Billy Madison right here. So that question would really be impossible to answer. If you asked me what's better, canola oil or avocado oil, I can tell you avocado by far. But both olive oil and avocado oil are great. This is actually a great price, and you can get it at Walmart. But these guys, Cobram Estate, make a 100% California single origin cold pressed EVOO. Wow, if you're an Amazon member, $6.29, this is a cooking olive oil. Here's my quick little spiel. When you're buying olive oil, only cook with, in my opinion, only finish with extra virgin, because if it's just regular olive oil, it's been too processed in my opinion. But see how it says 100% California here, 100% California? That means it's not made with mystery olives from around the world. It's single origin. Even better would be single estate, but that's only for extra virgin finishing. And it's made with high quality olives. This is actually a great deal. So this is the bottle I would cook with, because you could technically finish with it or make salad dressings, but I have a premium bottle at home that's smaller than this, that's $10, that I use as a finishing oil. To make olive oil from this, it just gets refined at higher heats, and you can potentially damage some of the antioxidants here and just refine it a little too much. So we cook with extra virgin olive oil. If you're a Costco member, write this down. They're 100% Italian extra virgin olive oil, or they're 100% California Sacramento Valley olive oil extra virgin is my favorite cooking one. Once again, 100% Italian extra virgin olive oil and the California one, not the organic Italian, the 100% Italian. So This is great because it's also rich in antioxidants and polyphenols, which attack free radicals in your body. The funny thing is, you know what causes free radicals? I feel like art's a free radical sometimes, right? It's like, canola oil. Canola oil is so highly processed and refined. Not this one per se because it's expeller pressed, but it's still not great. Regular canola oil is so processed and refined that it actually alters the fatty acid in here, process it at such high heat with a chemical called hexane, it actually destroys your cells. It does the opposite of what the olive oil did. So I hope that makes sense. Now, go to avocado oil. These are two or three of my favorite brands. Chosen, Primal, and then Marion's from Costco. Avocado oil actually lowers your bad cholesterol, raises your good one, and it's the perfect swap for canola oil, which is a high heat, neutral flavored oil. This is the same, but this is not nearly as processed. It's actually minimally processed, has a great health benefits, and it's really, really good for you, whereas the canola oil is crap, in my opinion. So that's my little spiel. Not spiel, Art. Spiel.
Spiel, okay. Julio has a question. Hey, Art, how does Bobby enjoy sushi to meet his lifestyle?
You know what's funny? I don't like sushi. I ate it more when I was younger. And if you read a book called Real Food, Fake Food, 95% of the sushi out there is fake, inferior quality, and mystery fish. Unless you get the really, really good stuff, I don't want it. Tuna's high-end mercury. It's just not for me. I prefer not to eat that. I'd rather have a nice piece of wild salmon, good quality farm-raised salmon, some wild cod, something like that.
I gotta get caught up on the super chats here. Maximiliano Rodriguez, $5. Is there any other beer that would be good other than the organic Michelob ones?
Well, yeah, some German beers are glyphosate-free. You would just have to do the research. So I would go online and search glyphosate-free beers. A lot of German ones are. And you don't always have to get organic, but they have to be glyphosate-free and not sprayed with Roundup.
And Jerry Castiglione, Bill, $4.99. Hi, guys. Thank you for all you do for us.
Well, thank you, Jerry. Thank you. Appreciate that. Okay, let's go selfie style.
Oh, Kelly Weinstein, $4.99. Hey! Just because I appreciate Flav City, the new cookbook is the gift I'm giving to my family and friends this year.
Thank you, Kelly. So in the description box is obviously the link for the new cookbook. I encourage you to share it with your friends, Santa Claus, Hanukkah, Harry, they're all gonna love it. Also down below, we just dropped 1,500 units of my new Flav City Immunity Tea. It's the immune-boosting tea powder, the powdered version of my liquid version with turmeric, ginger, black pepper, MCT oil. It's best-in-class ingredients. We've already sold half of our lots in the first half of the day. So use my link down below, you're gonna love it. And then my Amazon shop page is down there for all my kitchen gear that I use. If you wanna get some presents for the people in your life who love to cook.
Another super chat here, Katie Benson, $10.
Katie!
Hey, Bobby and Art, how is the avocado oil from Thrive?
I have to check. So basically, if the avocado oil isn't made from and made in either California or Mexico, I wouldn't get it. Like the Trader Joe's one is Mexican avocados produced in Italy. No, why would you take avocados, ship them all the way to Italy, where they can potentially mix it with inferior oils and canola oil and rancid oil and send it back? No way. It's gotta be avocados from Mexico and then produced either there, specifically the Michoacán region. Watch Rotten, it's a documentary on Netflix called The Avocado Episode, or Primal Kitchen actually, I believe, uses California avocados for their virgin. You want to try something special? This is extra virgin California avocado oil. I have it at home. You've probably seen it. The color of this oil, you can do what you want to do. It's vibrantly green. And if you could smell it, it smells like actual pressed avocados. You walk off the moon floating like a balloon. You say it's never too late and it's never too soon. Take it from me. It's kind to me. What's that again?
Does fresh turmeric need to be organic?
Negatory, it does not. Whew, that was fun. Okay, selfie style. Viviana's gonna use that for something, I know that. That was good because I had a lot of room here.
Yeah.
And it's kind of smooth, I can moonwalk like this, you know? It's pretty bad arse. Okay guys, we're live in living color on the north side of Chicago. His name is Arthur T, my name is Bobby P. We're gonna shop along with y'all. How do you store
Bobby
olive?
A, wouldn't it, if you're going on that?
Good point. How do you store olive and avocado oil? Room temperature in a dark, cool spot, never next to the oven or direct heat. I saw something about honey here. Where is that? And then a super chat just came through.
I got a Mariah Carey song stuck in my head.
Well, is wildflower honey truly better for allergies? Does King Arthur know Bobby? And how often does Bobby eat fish a week? Fish There's once King a week. Wildflower honey. Actually, it all depends where the honey's from. If you eat local honey, that'll help with local allergies. But wildflower honey isn't better than necessarily anyone else. Okay, so a couple super chats here.
Salvador Bentley, $2. What countries are best for wild caught salmon?
Canada, USA is great. That's really the two I go with.
Rachel Murray,
$5.
Just ordered some immunity today. Any word on the shipment on the signed cookbook?
Rachel, your cookbook went out last week. It takes 7 to 10 business days. And then Art and I just dropped off all the cookbooks that were ordered on Friday. So they should be there in 7 to 10 days. Rachel, coming your way. What are your thoughts on Costco organic ghee? We don't have it around here, but it's good. Even better if it's the Carrington Farms grass-fed ghee. Okay, what bacon options do you recommend in Whole Foods? It's slim pickings, and let's go take a look because, so pork is the most
the other white meat
underappreciated protein at the grocery store. I call it the Rodney Dangerfield of the grocery store because it gets no respect. What do I mean by that? Well, you can get organic chicken. You can't get organic pork, except for one thing I'll show you. You can get grass-fed beef, right? You can't get pasture-raised pork. You can get organic chicken. You can't get organic pork. And that's a problem, except for here. They do have, right here. This is relatively new. It's from Canada. What up, Kelly H? Organic ground pork. Now, I bought this. I used this for some lasagna this weekend. It's good, but it's nowhere near as tasty as pasture-raised pork. So most grocery stores won't have this. They'll have factory farm GMO pork. So if you're at the grocery store, this is the best you can do. But to find a locally sourced pasture-raised pork and other animal meat, go to a website called eatwild.com. I talk about it in our best-selling cookbook a lot. Type in your zip code. It'll tell you all local farms or co-ops where you can buy pasture-raised chicken, pork, and grass-fed beef. In Chicagoland, there's a bunch. And pasture-raised pork has the best texture, flavor, and fattiness compared to any ground pork you've ever had in your life or pork chops. It is literally mind-blowing how good it is. So, that's the best you can do here, but keep in mind, unless it's organic sausage, the pork eats a GMO feed, and it's going to be basically factory-farmed pork. I like pasture-raised pork that are free to forage. The best you can do, but it's expensive, is this, Art. Right here. Applegate. Applegate makes Sunday bacon that's organic, or this one right here. But look at the price. It's $7.99 for 8 ounces. It's $16 a pound, which is insane in the membrane.
That's why I'm gonna burn.
Because I can go online and order pasture-raised pork bacon from a number of farms and get it for about $12 to $14 a pound, and it's miles better than that. Go to eatwild.com, find a local farm, go there, order it, okay? Don't order from ButcherBox. That's not pasture-raised beef. It's actually GMO-fed pork. It's nothing special about it. There's nothing I like about ButcherBox. Their beef is nothing special. Their chicken is nothing special. That's not pasture-raised. So go find a local spot, taste it, and be like, ooh-wee, that Bobby knows what he's talking about. That's delicious.
Rachel Murray, $5. Super chat. What does it mean when they indicate heritage breed pork?
Great question. Heritage breed pork and heritage breed chicken is very important because factory farming has gotten so prevalent, Rachie, that almost all grocery store chicken comes from one or two breeds. Almost all grocery store pork comes from one or two breeds. These are modern breeds that are bred to get big and fat quickly so they can be slaughtered quickly because of, hey, it must be the money. Heritage breed means they haven't changed the genes from back in the day. It's slower to grow, but it's healthier and it tastes better. Pasture-raised is good. One step better, and Rachel, I'm going to make a video about that, is pasture-raised and heritage breed. Very important. My favorite chicken that Rachel gets too from Thrive Market is called Cook's Venture out of Arkansas. It's heritage breed, slow-grown, pasture-raised, non-GMO. No kidding you. It is the best chicken you will ever taste in your life. I'll have a promo code next month But when you go to Thrive Market using my promo code for my live streams every Friday, try the pasture-raised heritage chicken. It's delicious.
I'm confused. I thought erythritol is bad sugar too. How is it better than Splenda? Thanks.
Well, have we talked about erythritol today?
It's a question.
Yeah, so...
That wasn't a me question.
No, erythritol... Erythritol is not great, but it's way better than Splenda, sucralose, aspartame. Those are really bad. Erythritol is ideally made from non-GMO sugar alcohol from corn. Much better than fake made from NutraSweet and chemicals. But if you have a sensitive gut, it's still not good for you. You're better off with pure monk fruit.
Best hot dog.
Oh, good question. So, by far it's this one. You can get it everywhere. Look at this. The operative word, 100% grass-fed. They have them at Walmart, Trader Joe's, they got them everywhere. But it's tricky because sometimes you'll see this. Look at this. These are honest hot dogs as opposed to
dishonest,
filthy
blatant
dogs.
Blatant lies.
Yeah, blatant lies. Pasture raised. Oh, great. Pasture raised. I'm going to get it. Do we see grass fed anywhere? Nope. Now, it is GAP 4 certified, which is amazing, but it's not grass fed. I don't know why it's not, so I'd rather you go with that. Grass fed means the animal never eats grain. This eats grain, GMO grain. This eats only grass, which means the farm is carbon neutral. Any methane that comes out of his butthole is sequestered by the plants and the grass. Better for the animal, for us, more nutrients in there. Better for the farmer, better for the environment. Winning! High five! Okay, you guys want to go by the dairy? What do y'all want to do? Go Southie style. That's what I want to do. Woo! We're on a roll, baby.
Ellen girls in the house. Honest hot dogs versus
exactly.
Honest hot dogs.
Can you make a video on authentic Chicago-style hot dog? Sounds like a video art would be.
You wouldn't use any of these. You'd use Vienna beef.
True that, Holmes.
And a poppy seed bun from
Where you buy the bones for making bone broth. ShepherdMeats.com. A Flav City fan started it. Buy the knuckle bones, the neck bones. Use Flav City for 15% off. Can you please cover canned beans and other canned vegetables? Do you have to buy organic? Great question. Let's go to the canned food aisle. Hey, I hope you're all having a great time. We're live on a Tuesday afternoon in Whole Foods in Chicago, taking live questions for a shop along. This is super fun. As I burp into the microphone.
Alan Girl says, hi guys, I just came here to say when you go back home, perhaps Santa has visited you.
Hey! I like me some Santa Claus a bit. Thank you.
Thanks for the heads up, Alan Girl.
Thank you, Alan. So,
have a good day.
Big wall of beans, which during peak pandemic was decimated here because everyone's stocking up on that. Question, let's do a quick poll. When you're buying beans, canned beans or fresh, do they have to be organic or should you buy conventional? Organic or conventional? In the meantime, look at these fancy beans here. Look at these. What is this? Wow, these are super fancy. Wow, why are these so expensive? $2.79? Are they pressure cooked? Organic farms.
Julio, $2. Which heirloom chocolate bar from time to time?
Heirloom chocolate?
Yeah, which heirloom chocolate bar from time to time?
I don't think there's any such thing as heirloom chocolate. There's really no such thing. My favorite chocolate bar is actually made from Evolved Chocolate. They make paleo chocolate bars that are amazing. I'll show you that later on.
Only a matter of time. Heirloom everything. Brenda Bittinger, $5 super chat. Bicep paralink. Keep it up, pair.
Brenda, thank you. All right. What's the voting? Is it mostly organic, conventional? Boom, boom, down, informer. Okay.
I've seen organic, I've seen conventional.
Okay, so.
My gut says more people are saying organic.
Your gut is made of heirloom popcorn, is it?
Heirloom organic.
So, it's funny, because beans aren't on the dirty dozen, but beans score high in glyphosate. What is glyphosate? It's the active ingredient in Roundup. Which makes no sense because they don't really spray beans directly, but because Roundup is so prevalent and sprayed on so much corn and soy in this country, it's affected the soil in such multitude that it really affects legumes, all beans, really affects wheat, and really affects oats. We eat those three things in so many darn things. So if you don't get organic wheat, oats, and beans, they could be high in glyphosate. Independent studies have been done time and time by EWG, the Environmental Working Group, so get organic. So, knowing that, get whatever you want. Look at, for 99 cents, get an organic finger garbanzo beans. What I prefer to do is buy organic dried garbanzo beans. See, just garbanzo beans and salt. Soak them overnight in H2O, pressure cook them, and then make a recipe with that, because if these are not pressure cooked, which they might, they also have lectins. Dr. Gundry talks about anti-nutrients, lectins, and they're really bad for you, but if you pressure cook legumes, you get all the anti-nutrients away. So this is good to have on hand. And actually recently I took a couple cans of black beans, here, organic black beans, and I made with Rose in a video. By the way, are we loving Rose videos on Facebook? People love them. I love making it with her. We might make a video tonight, Rose and I, for Taco Tuesday. I digress. I made refried beans. We did it on live stream too. Canned beans, because I didn't have time to pressure cook them. They were delicious.
1,000 people.
1,000 people. Keep leaving comments down below. Okay.
Julio says, hey Art, it's called Beyond Good Chocolate Heirloom, carried at Sprouts. Well, we don't have Sprouts here, so.
Yeah, you know what? I've never heard of Beyond or heirloom chocolate. I mean, it's made with cacao plants, which I'm pretty sure haven't really been modified or anything. So I find that kind of weird.
I do eat heirloom cheese balls.
Well, Art has a special source for that, I believe, that no one else can get. What else while we're here? In the new cookbook, which I'm going to keep referencing, I guess, I have a recipe for 5 ingredient chicken enchiladas that are loco en la cabeza, tiene mucho sabor. Y yo usar este enchilada sauce, this one. Are you, 7. Look at this. Are you ready to have your mind blown? Look at these ingredients for enchilada sauce. I not only use it as the braising liquid in the pressure cooker, I also use it to top the enchiladas, because you only have 5 ingredients, you got to make them count. This or the Verde is great. But to be honest, even the Whole Foods one is great. There's absolutely no oil in here at all. A little bit of organic cornstarch, that's okay. And it's cheaper than the Siete. But this stuff is great. And that's the thing, in case you don't know about the cookbook, it's not just 55-ish 5 ingredient recipes. All my shopping knowledge, everything we're doing now, is in that cookbook. So I teach you before each chapter and each recipe that when you're shopping for sauces, dressings, dairy, what to look for, what to avoid, I give you specific product shout outs and tell you if you can't find that product, avoid these ingredients in the ones you're looking for. It's the ultimate guide to shopping that will go with the Bobby approved app and the barcode scanner when that comes out late next month. So once again, Amazon link is down below, the link in the description box, or just go on Amazon and search Flav City. You guys have made it a number one bestseller. It's ranking in the top 500 on Amazon, and I give you a high five for that. All
Richard
right.
Richard Marcotte, Southwest Airlines representative, $5. Pressure cooked bean, get rid of the lectins, same for tomatoes. This is really good information. Siete cashew queso is yummy as well.
Oh, dude, siete cashew queso is insane. Thank you, Richie boy. Yeah, the thing with tomatoes, I prefer to eat them raw because I never pressure cook them. Unless I put them into like a sauce or something, but a fresh tomato that's gorgeous, I would never cook or put any heat to, right? All right. Go selfie, Stella. I say hi.
Hello.
There he is, Arthur T. Another fun video idea. I become an Amazon shopper for the day, and I swap out all the products that they wanted to get that were bad with good ones. So when they get it, they're like, what is this? And then I pop up, and I'm like, hey, I did that. And they punch me in the face. It's a great idea, though, in theory, right?
I saw that part, right?
You got the Heinz tomato ketchup with 5 grams of sugar. I subbed it with the Primal Kitchen. They're like, I can't afford that. Too funny. Okay, where are we going next, Art? I don't know.
Rachel Murray, what's up? Armchair Guru. I saw a coffee pot in there, too. Hi, Art.
What's the best, did I say, low-carb straw bread?
Ice cream, please.
Oh, ice cream. Ice cream in the middle of winter. I don't know if I can talk about that.
It's always time for ice cream.
That's true. The best low-carb bread is Base Culture. And the first week of January, I'll have a great promo code for them because it's $9 at the grocery store. I think I'll have a 20% off directly from them. Their keto raisin bread and keto cheese bread is delicious. It tastes crazy good. Rose and I and Desi have it about 4 or 5 times a week.
Super chat from D Hub, $5. Is all these wild salmon from Chile good to eat?
I have never seen their wild salmon. Interesting. It's from Chile? No, I think you're confused. I think it's farm-raised salmon from Chile. I've never seen the wild. If it's the farm-raised from Chile, no, Chile has bad farming practices. I wouldn't get it.
Everything Ness. Hi, Bobby. Thanks for the helpful information and art. Thank you. Well, awesome personality. Two questions for you guys. What is the best flavor of vegetable broth, and what is the best vegan collagen?
Best vegan collagen is made by Sun Warrior. Check it out online. I don't use that much veggie broth or stock, so I don't know which one's the best. You just want to make sure there's no yeast extract in there or added sugar or stuff like that.
Question from Art, me. Is there such a thing as vegetable bone broth?
What do you say? Is that for you, Art?
Yeah.
What's the answer?
I'm asking you.
Oh, no, of course not, because there's no bones in vegetables. It'd be veggie broth at that point, right?
No, it was a dumb question.
Oh, it was from you. It was from you. I thought someone was asking. No. Oh, sale alert. One of the best Bobby-approved condiments on the market is here. These are paleo coconut aminos. But, wow, the price is great. If you're an Amazon shopper, $6.29. So what is this? This is teriyaki sauce that's paleo. So it's made with coconut aminos. What are coconut aminos? It's the sap from the coconut tree. And to make it teriyaki, they add real ingredients here. No sugar, no oils. This is the ingredient I use in the 5-ingredient wild rice, fried rice with chicken in the cookbook. And this one, I always have in my fridge too. This is garlic sauce aminos. So tasty. So good. I don't love plain aminos. It doesn't have enough umami or funk for me. But the teriyaki one or the garlic one is great.
We got a request. Can you go 4 products over?
Yes. Here? Oh, Goji! So what is gochujang? It's not only the last name of Brad Parham now, but gochujang is basically a fermented chili paste from Korea. Normally it has soy, maybe some cane sugar. Look at these ingredients. This is an umami bomb. There's no soy, there's no sugar, there's no canola oil. All these flavors are, some are fermented, some are spicy, some are sweet. This in here is umami. Use this for sauces, braises, marinades. We have a recipe for 5-ingredient short ribs, Korean short ribs in slaw, and I use it for the slaw dressing and I use it for the marinade. Oh my God, this stuff is amazing. Run, Forge, run! Cindy, go to Whole Foods and get this.
Cindy Sue is wanting us to check out Suntella by Lacanto. Keto Nutella, is it Bobby approved?
So I've had it. I will say the flavor is not great because it's made with sunflower seeds, not hazelnut. It has natural flavors. That being said, almost all keto Nutellas, keto maple syrups have natural flavors. So in that rare case, I'm okay with natural flavors because I'd rather have it than a bunch of sugar, but it's not that tasty. Go on Amazon, get a company called Pure, P-Y-U-R-E. They make a keto Nutella that's amazing. What is this, Art? Vegetable sriracha.
Welcome, Viviana. We mentioned you earlier.
Hey, Vivi. Oh, yeah, you missed a great dance move, Vivi. Tomato, jalapeno, more butternut squash. I don't like that. Listen, when you're making sriracha, we don't need vegetables in sriracha. My favorite sriracha is made by these guys, Sky Valley. It's a fermented chili paste. Don't be sneaking in carrots, butternut squash.
If you had to choose between sriracha and carrot ketchup, what would you have?
Carrot ketchup. That's what I would do.
Jacob Langford, $2 super chat. How do I get plums that are red on the inside? LOL.
How do you get what?
Plums red on the inside.
I don't get it.
Huh?
I don't get it.
He's asking a question.
They're usually the ones that are...
Aren't they called red plums?
Yeah, red plums that have like the dark red or like purple skin. I don't know. Isn't there like a joke with Will Ferrell about that?
I don't know.
Something like that.
Feeling my plums?
Yeah, there you go. That's the one.
Super chat. You got £5.
5 pounds?
From Rybags. The UK is so behind when it comes to quality products. It's such a shame. Keep up the good work.
I've heard that big time, that so behind. They don't have more than half the stuff. If you have it, it's so expensive. It's tough, man. I feel you.
Viviana, catch it on the replay. She says you've got moved like Jagger.
Honestly, it was very Jagger-esque. Like, people on Whole Foods were like, wow, it's amazing. Wow.
Protein bars and granola bars are showing up in the mix here.
Yeah, we talked about protein bars last time. There's a big wall of those. You know, we talked about it so much last time, I'd rather talk about something else. Keep on giving me your suggestions where you want to go.
Rapeseed oil, organic, is it good?
If you're going to use it, it has to be organic and expeller pressed, but rapeseed oil is another word for canola oil.
What dog food is best? What are your thoughts on Costco organic ghee? There's also a keto brownie mix by Lakento at Costco. What do you think? That was all in the same question.
Ingredients for the keto brownie mix are good, except for the natural flavors, but it's okay. Costco ghee is good. Ideally, it's the grass-fed one better. Search Flav City dog food. I got you covered. Boom! Goes the dynamite.
Dynamite goes boom. Best granola bars.
Oh, granola bars. Let's take a look.
Going back to Clown Shoe Cam.
I assume that'd be over by the...
And Stingman says Milkadamia milk.
Stingman's like a broken record. Florida sucks. Milkadamia is good.
Gochujang once you go to the cheesemonger.
Oh, you know what? I never go there. They kind of give me a bad look all the time, so I don't know if I want to go there. Granola.
Coffee pot. We already hit the bulk spices.
Yeah, we did. We were there, my man. We were there. Where would the granola bars be? Maybe they're by the protein bars. How long have you been on for?
Super chat from Erica Marshall. $1.99. Would you recommend Dr. D's probiotic drink?
I don't know that one.
Thank you, though.
I do not. Yeah, but thank you so much. Oh, we were talking about chocolate. Check this out. Here it is. You want one of the most clean chocolates on the market? It's going to be this one right here. Evolved, the same company that makes keto cups, makes paleo chocolate bars with ingredients that are insane. So look at this. Organic cacao, coconut sugar instead of cane sugar, cashews, cocoa butter, Himalayan pink salt. It's not that much sugar at all. 6 grams is a teaspoon and a half of coconut sugar. Any one of these is amazing. So darn good. Go ahead.
If somebody wants to make their own bone broth, where can they get grass-fed bones?
So a Flav City fan started a company called shepherdmeats.com, and they have grass-fed bones. Just search bones, because I can't find grass-fed bones at any grocery store. They also have a keto nut butter bar. So instead of coconut sugar now, they're putting in pure monk fruit. They're not putting erythritol or stevia. So for people who have issues with that, they don't have to worry about it. Look at those ingredients. I mean, these are insane. The flavor of this one's great. Look at those macros. We're talking 3 net carbs per serving. Get this bar in Whole Foods. It's $5, a little pricey, but it's the cleanest chocolate and it tastes divine.
Gochujang says that some Whole Foods have grass-fed bones.
Oh yeah, I've never seen it. Good to know, Brad. Are there granola bars here? We talked about all these protein bars last time.
I feel like, is it near the cereal or not?
Oh, yeah, good call. Let's go over there, Art. Thank you.
Can you check the mustard section?
We have a whole video about condiments, and a surprising amount of mustards have natural flavors in them, but I believe the mustards here don't. The yellow mustards. My favorite mustard is Stone Ground. Okay, breakfast aisle. If you're a Costco shopper, my favorite granola bars by far are the paleo bars by Autumn's Gold. Autumn Gold are amazing. Now, a lot of people will come into a grocery store and be like, oh, like Kind bars are really good, or Nature Valley. Okay, so we're gonna get Nature Valley. Oats and honey. So we never just look at the front, we read the ingredients, but oats have to be organic in my opinion, otherwise they score high in glyphosate. They're not organic. I can promise you this is not pure honey. We have a whole video about fake honey. This is probably honey cut with corn syrup, sugar, and other garbage. But whole grain oats, not organic. Cane sugar to the tune of 11 grams for 2 bars. 5.5 teaspoons is just about 1.5 teaspoons of cane sugar per bar. Canola oil, GMO processed, highly inflammatory canola oil. Rice flour, fake honey, most likely. More sugar, natural flavor, and GMO soy, less of them. Honestly, I don't even know why this is at Whole Foods. They're not supposed to have any GMO products. It doesn't say non-GMO. This is a bad dessert. I can't believe I could actually see this here. This is a travesty, in my opinion. So
I think it tastes good.
I was going to say that. So we'll keep going, right?
You and me, Viviana.
What looks
She's
good
a fan
here?
Too.
So this company is actually at Costco, and they always have natural flavors. But let's see, made good. Anyone seen this at Costco? So gluten-free oats with a star, organic. So far, so good. Agave syrup, better than cane sugar, not ideal, because a lot of people don't realize that agave has the same amount of fructose as cane sugar. Not ideal, but not terrible. Chocolate chips obviously have cane sugar. Brown rice syrup instead of cane sugar. Sunflower oil, it's not expeller pressed, not ideal. Bunch of vegetables, and then natural flavor. How much sugar? One bar has a teaspoon and a half of agave and brown rice syrup. So, not Bobby approved, but way better. What you got from there?
$2 super chat from A. Vic. Organic or A2 milk?
Oh, organic by far. A2 refers to the protein structure to make it more digestible, but it's not organic. If you can get organic A2, that's great. Better would be grass-fed. Better than for everyone, right?
Sir, Winmuller, Art, has anyone ever told you that you look like Willem Dafoe? Nobody has.
Yeah, exactly.
Are you saying I do?
Cascadian Farm. Organic oats, tapioca syrup as the sweetener, dark chocolate once again. See, everyone cheaps out and uses these highly processed oils. Same profile. So, to be honest, there's no Bobby approved ones here unless they have paleo ones. No. So there's not one Bobby approved. That's pretty sad. So the best one by far is at Whole Foods is Autumn's Gold. These are pretty interesting. These aren't a granola bar, but it's a, what is it? A soft baked almond flour bar. Look at these ingredients here. Oh, peanut oil, what the heck, man? Peanut oil and coconut oil, everything else, look at this. Honey, I bet they're using good honey. Peanuts, almonds, seeds, and then they have to throw in crappy peanut oil. Caitlin, can you email Caitlin, Art? All right, this is not Bobby approved. Oh, this is very.
Can people buy those Flav City masks?
Oh, no, that was made for me by some lady on Instagram. I suppose you could ask her to make it for you. Go to Instagram, @TheMaskMama, and tell her you want the Flav City one, the one he's wearing now that looks like this. Or take a screenshot here. Send it to her.
Sherry, no, you don't add it to it. The total includes the added sugar. It's just breaking
yes.
out the sugars that are already in there from the sugars that they're adding to
That's
it.
That's a great point. Yeah, that's a bummer, but I'll show you.
Bummer, dude. It's
a bummer, dude.
Where's it? Bummer man.
So,
bummer man.
They don't have it here, but.
Julio, you, $2 super chat. Look at Nature's Path Smart Brand Cereal.
Nature's Path Smart what?
Smart Brand Cereal.
Nature's Path Smart?
Smart Brand.
I don't think
it is. It looks smart.
Oh, Smart Brand. Okay, so Nature's Path. Organic is great for grains like this, but let's see. Wheat bran, organic. Oat fiber, organic. Cane sugar, psyllium husk, oat bran, oat flour. Interesting. How much sugar? 2 teaspoons, Julio, of added sugar per 3/4 cup. That's too much, Julio. That's 2 teaspoons of white sugar. Otherwise, not terrible, but not great.
Joseph Cavanaugh, $2 Canadian. That's a toonie up there. Come to Canada to do a shopping trip.
Dude, I want, when things settle down, I want to do a meetup in Toronto, have you guys show me all the greatest spots, and then we'll do a haul together.
The fiber is superior, though, Julio says.
Yeah.
How much goes there?
There's a ton of.
But the fiber. How much fiber? Where do you prefer fibra?
Oh my God, 17 grams of fiber?
That's a lot of fiber.
That's colon blow.
Where? I don't see it.
Right here, dietary fiber, 17 grams. That's huge.
Dang.
I agree.
There you go.
It's just too bad they're putting that.
You need that.
Oh, it's because they're putting psyllium husk or dumpy psyllium husk powder.
That's a lot of fiber. It's like Metamucil plus cereal.
Yeah, totally.
My wife thinks that Art looks like a younger Bryan Adams. I'm fine with that.
That's a new
one.
I
like some of his music.
That's a new one.
See you, Ray. Have a good one, man. Viviana wants a meet up in NYC. So do I.
That's overdue, too. NYC probably won't happen, I'm guessing, until...
Long time.
Yeah. Fall of next
Lady
year, maybe.
Lady Marie, you were not crazy. That is a lot of fiber.
That insane amount of, like, don't stray from the bathroom amount of fiber. Go selfie stuff. All right, what time is it also?
Actually, let me grab my favorite cereal.
Go for
that
it.
I saw today.
All right, we've been on for how long? Oh, an hour exactly, nice. What do we got here? Oh yeah, look at what Art likes here.
Wait, is it gonna be reversed?
I'll show you. So Art saw this today.
Has anybody tried this? Hazelnut cocoa pillows. I mean, look at that. It looks like there's like oozing Nutella in the middle of these.
Let's see the ingredients.
The first ingredient is the Nutella portion of it. Organic hazelnut and cocoa cream, which is sugar, sunflower oil, hazelnut, cocoa butter, the milk, lecithin, natural flavor. Then you get into the starches. So
yeah,
you'd think it'd be more than 9 grams.
I agree, to be honest.
But that's 3/4 of a cup.
That's the same as that guy. What? How funny is that? There's 1 gram difference. That is absurd.
I'm guessing this is probably tastier.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it. Maybe they should merge hazelnut and Smart Brand.
You know, I'm considering this.
All right, guys, we've been on for an hour. We got to finish up and get a few more ingredients and then go home. We're going to make a video. Super Chef from SD. Please do a video on cooking lion's mane mushrooms. Wow, I've actually never seen that. I've seen chanterelles and shiitakes, but I'll check that out. Thank you for that. Rose and I are going to make some ground beef tacos tonight. So awesome time hanging out. I had a good time. How about you, Art?
I had a blast.
I had a blast. So live cook-alongs are always live shop-alongs are always super duper fun. But that's it. We'll be back later in the week for more live streams. Yeah, Jen H., we dropped your book in the mail today. Everybody signed it for you. Should take about 10 days maybe to get to Canada. Everyone who bought a book last week, it shipped today. So give it 7 to 10 business days for medium mail. Sourdough versus regular whole wheat bread. If the sourdough is organic and naturally fermented, that's the best. Okay, we gotta go. Great time hanging out. Hashtag keep on cooking. Mad love. Peace.